Jordan is in Kailua, Hawaii on EWTN iPhone app. Hello, Jordan. Welcome.
Hey, hello to the all-knowing Wizard of Oz coffin.
My goodness.
Dr. Hahn.
Thank you, Jordan.
Jordan, you're a perceptive fellow.
I'm experiencing a whole layer of butter being applied here. What
about you? You may remember me from the forum, Patrick. But anyways.
Cool, Jordan. Welcome. Good to have you. How can Dr. Hahn help you?
Yes, thanks. Question for Dr. Hahn. I am a Protestant and seeking, open to the idea of the Catholic Church being the church that Christ founded. And one of the things I'm wrestling with a lot is papal authority, papal infallibility. I guess that's fairly predictable. But so did you struggle with that in your process, and how did that look for you?
I sure did. You know, I must admit that I made a shift that I thought was small and subtle, but it proved to be substantial and significant. I moved away from a conception of salvation as a personal relationship with Jesus, which it still is, but it's a covenant bond. And I came to understand that covenant in ancient Israel was a family bond, and not just a nuclear family, but the extended family. And so when you trace the covenants by which God is fathering his family down through the ages of salvation history, you see a marriage with Adam, and then you see a household aboard the Ark of Noah, a tribe of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, 12 tribes forming one national family with Moses. And then the new covenant is new as the fulfillment of all of that, because now God is fathering a worldwide family. At every single stage of salvation history, you see father figures, not political authorities, not hierarchs who are just simply institutional overlords, but Adam as the husband, Noah as the father, Abraham as the chieftain, Moses and Joshua and the judges as father figures, David and Solomon and Rehoboam. And some are good and some are not, but God is able to write straight with crooked lines. And so when you see the Father sending the Son and giving authority to the 12, but only giving the keys of the kingdom to one of the 12, Peter, with the Old Testament as the background in Isaiah 22, much to my shock, I discovered that there was a very strong basis in Isaiah 22 for not only the king having 12 royal ministers, but the king giving to one and only one of them that primacy as prime minister represented by the keys of the kingdom. And in Isaiah 22, just like in Matthew 16, you have not only primacy, but succession and office. So God is still fathering a family through Christ the Son, who's working by the Holy Spirit. But the greatness of a father consists in him fathering one family, not three or four. And so when it comes to the Catholic Church, in its unity of doctrine, its unity of moral teaching, its unity of worship, there's a great diversity, to be sure, but it's a kind of symphonic diversity that doesn't threaten the unity. If anything, it deepens and enriches it, because God is a father who's raised one family, but he's kept them united to fulfill his Son's promise, the gates of hell will not prevail. And plus, he also said, I will build my church on this rock. He didn't ask Peter to go build him a church. And so the glory and greatness of the Catholic Church is not a human achievement, but God's fatherly accomplishment. And that's how I came to see authority in family and covenantal terms.
How can Jordan go deeper? I know you've got a series with St. Joseph Communications, the first epistle of Peter. I have a feeling you've went in print deeper. What books or resources would you recommend?
I would recommend Rome's Sweet Home as a start. I would also recommend A Father Who Keeps His Promises, where I trace the covenants down through the ages of salvation history and show how this principle of continuity abides. Even when you have bad father figures, God is able to kind of override all of their fallibility. I mean, we believe that as Christians with Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. These are fallible men, but the Holy Spirit was able to override their fallibility and render them infallible in writing Scripture. Why can't the Holy Spirit also override the fallibility of everybody from Peter to John, Paul, and Benedict so that the family of God gets the Word of God through the Spirit of God with clarity and authority?
How's that, Jordan?
I appreciate it.
You're in trouble, Jordan. We're going to pray for you, and I'll raise a toast when you enter full communion with the Catholic Church, Jordan.
All right, thanks.
Bless
you, sir. Great call, Jordan. Thanks for that.